Parapreta Sanitation. Part 10, Collection of Different Ecosun and Urine Diversion Toilets.
There have been many attempts to find good toilet models. Following the principle of reuse, there was a lot of toilets developed with urine diversion, so that urine flows in one direction and excreta normally fall down into the other one. But many combinations have been on the market, mostly on a very small scale. I want to show you some of these models. And for example, this is a squat model from China. And this has been developed for people who prefer squatting toilets. So this front part is for urine. So the urine would go in here, the person would squat here. And this part is for excreta. So we have a hole here. And the whole thing must not be touched. This is a big advantage in this model, so people can just operate it with their feet and then just squat without touching anything. Then this is a model from Sweden. Most of the modern urine diversion toilets come from Sweden. And this is one where in the front part of the sitting toilet, urine is collected separately with a single pipe. And then excreta go into something what is very much like a conventional toilet, so this is not very different from that part. Then we have the combination of urine diversion and dry toilet. So this is one where urine goes into this front part and excreta fall in the back part. A lot of work has been done to find very, very simple solutions, and so there are also developments like this very, very simple urinal. And this is just two jerry cans with a connection, and all this is a very, very simple, almost no-cost urinal where urine can be collected in the jerry can itself. We have more models, and also a lot of them have been made for self-construction in inside projects, and we have models that are self-made from concrete, for example, and these ones are well, sometimes not so beautiful, but this is something what we do here with students so that they can learn for themselves how to build toilets. And there are some of these models that can be seen here. These are for example, very simple toilet just made from concrete with simple plastic material to collect urine. Here's a little pipe, and so this would make a simple toilet. So there is such a model from the other side, so just concrete construction, and well, just some more attempts like this. Some worked very well, some not so well, but the main thing is that it is actually possible that people build their own toilets for very, very little money. Now, after all this work and where we have been finding different solutions in different parts of the world, a lot of the innovation coming from Sweden, from the Eco Sunrest group, we finally got in touch with lactic acid fermentation. And with this, all of a sudden, we can come to completely different solutions. And one of them is really surprising, because it gets back to something very, very simple. And that is a camping toilet. This toilet here is used in camper vans, in boats. And it's a very simple model. And this is just having a normal toilet bowl. When they are used as they are used now, there is some chemicals added. So that means we have people putting toxic chemicals in there, and then they flush. So that's the normal operation. With that, we have too much dilution again, so we don't need this flushing. But we can use this type of toilet, because it just opens with a little handle, so when we want to use the toilet, we can just open this hole here, And then normally there will be very little getting dirty. And when people clean the toilet, they should use a spray bottle or a little shower. And with that, the toilet can be used with very little water. Of course, now this would start smelling and produce gas. And that is why we add lactic acid bacteria first. So we would have a load of this bacteria. And so this would be first adding a mix of this bacteria into the toilet. And then it is used. And after the usage of the toilet, the material is closed off from air, and we get a lactic acid fermentation that is not producing any gas and not producing any odor. And with that, we can operate such a toilet very easily. And this is now a pathway of development that we are following at, as one of the main development lines. But of course, lactic acid fermentation can be used also in other toilet systems, even in pit latrines that are often very smelly. So if there is some lactic acid bacteria added, that will improve the process a lot. What we need now is a larger type of such a camping toilet model. So that this would be holding the whole excreta of a family for minimum 1 week, that we could have 1 week emptying cycles, and with that there would be the possibility to collect excreta with very little dilution and then bring this to a composting place outside the village, outside the city, and there the composting would take place with addition of charcoal and also of woody waste. We need a lot of fine woody material to compensate for the excess of liquid from the urine, because we want to compost the urine as well. And with that, we have a system that is basically very simple, where relatively little transportation is needed, and where after all this composting, vermicomposting, we will have very good rich black soil that can be used in agriculture to improve the soil quality. So this was an overview of some of the toilet models, and I can assure you there are hundreds more and thousands and hundred thousands of attempts to find good solutions. And it's a tricky issue, and I'm really curious to see where development will get us. If you are further interested, please click on some of these flickering subjects.